Hi guys, this is Cobra Tom.
And Brennan Rose.
And we are doing the final Iron Grenadier video for 2019. And we are gonna just kinda show you a plan that we have. We're not gonna be really doing very much with this right at the moment. But we just kinda wanted to show you our final video, just kinda what my plan is to just kinda go over a bunch of our figures and kind of just look at some of the stuff that we did and just kind of say goodbye to 2019 because we're getting close to the end of the year and we'll be doing our normal Christmas stuff and we'll be doing
advent calendars.
So hope you stay tuned for that. Here we have the BB-8 playset, and here we have the Venom, the other Venom Lily figure.
This figure, I had white hair at the time and a mohawk, so we took Storm. We had Ed Hellman do it for us, and yeah,
that's really cool. And she is sitting in her, well, we're part of the Destro Space Force, but she's sitting in her on her throne on her space base.
And I like the theme of the colors. It was red and blue. So on the back of the jacket and on the front is blue.
Yep.
Well, he doesn't want to sit today.
Well, why don't you try to make her sit so she can look nice, at least for this part.
Fine. How'd you get her sitting there?
I don't know. Didn't take me anything to get her to sit there. So, all right, next I'm going to show some figures and some other stuff that we've been working on this year. I'm gonna be doing some assembly on this. As you can see, it kinda got a little dusty sitting there, but now this piece goes here. This piece goes right here. Hopefully I can turn the light so that you guys can see that a little bit. Lighting is always an issue with us because we don't have a very good lighting system here. We haven't quite got that far. Get a new one. So that goes there. I know that that's not a very good lighting thing. And I'm now going to switch sides over here for the bigger block. It's this block. Once again, a little dusty, but here's this piece. Now I have to remember how this goes. It has to go a little bit like, okay, all right. So then we gotta go back. There. Now, I'm going to go into the middle here and very quickly put this back up. Slide this back into here. Whoops. See, mine's a little touchy. So now that's on there. Pretty soon I'm going to be doing the stickers here. But I still need one more thing. For the last piece of this part, we have the machine gun. Technically, this would be a laser cannon for Star Wars, but I'm going to use this as a machine gun. There is a specific way it goes in because it's got a key hole there, right there, and that slides in there. And the turret moves around. So that's pretty nice. And if you want it stationary, there is a place that it locks and another place that it locks. And this has many, many foot pegs on it, like a lot of foot pegs. Oh, well, okay, there we go. I am going to be putting some stickers on. Hopefully you guys can see that. There's one. So I'm going to be trying to do this. I am going to be putting another sticker here. There we go. And the final sticker for this side, right in the middle. Not perfect, but it'll be good enough. And on the other side, which will be even more difficult to see, has the same type of stickers. So hopefully you guys are seeing this and kind of enjoying this, hopefully. I get a bunch of thumbs down, then I'll know not to do this again. But I'm doing stickers here. Now here's B4. And B5. Actually, this might be even B6, actually. There. So now I can put this like that. Put this like that. Now I'm going to go to a different part of the thing and put in C1. Now, I already did this one before. Oh, shoot, my folks took off. Yeah, now you can hear the gravity thing, so. Okay, now we have all the E's, which go like 1, 2, like I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So looks like these ones are pretty skinny. the one. Hopefully I'm doing this right. E2. And then right here, it looks like I gotta put E2 and 3. These ones are really tiny. So, hopefully, me, who's not very dexterous, can do this, hopefully. This is why probably somebody else should have done this, but I don't have somebody else here, so. Problem with not being only very good at this. The person who probably would be very good at this is not here right now. Miss Venom Lily is at her mom's house. So, the only person you get is me. We're down to the last four here, guys, so hopefully I can get this figured out pretty quickly. That's kind of weird. I don't see where G. Okay. Sorry guys, this is taking me a minute actually. I apologize. This shouldn't be taking so long, but alright, I think it's actually under here that I gotta put that. Okay, I think I see where I gotta put this one. That, and a normal person would be able to just go, oh yeah, this is G and F and all that, and I, however, am just not very good with these kinds of things. But then again, if you don't ever try, then how will you know? So I try it and I do my best, and you guys can point and laugh, that's okay, I can live with that. Wouldn't be the first time. Sorry if my head's right in the way, but I gotta put it in the right spot. There you go. Now, that's gotta go. I got two more, and I see where the other two have to go. Here's G1. Alright, there's G1, and G2 goes on the other side. Sorry, you guys, you probably couldn't even see me putting the last one in there, but this one goes hopefully you can see me do this here. Goes into a little spot here. There it is, the complete base. And I really like this base. I think it's really cool. Sorry it kind of took me so long to do this. It It's not my forte, but I'm just going to do a really, really, really quick rundown on some action figures here at the last part of this. And then this video will be done. It's going to be kind of a long one. Hope you guys like it. Here is, I know this is Queen Amidala. Oops, there goes Venom Lily. And here goes Queen Amidala. She's kind of her... This one's really difficult to get because the foot peg is in kind of a funny place and her dress does not make it very easy for her to stand. Here is the Royal Executioner, the Iron Executioner. And for right now, I'm just going to have her be bodyguard by him. And I don't think anybody is going to attack the Iron Lady, the Venom Lily, if this guy is standing here. Not a lot of guys are going to take that up. Here is an Ed Hellman creation that is going to get its own review very soon. Well, not very soon, but will get its own review, Dread Rose. And she's kind of the Iron Grenadier drill sergeant and kind of all around kind of bad person, but she looks awesome. And I think one time I said that she was a Wonder Woman, but she's really not. I'm not sure what he made her out of, but I love the jacket and the boots and everything. Here's the Hooded Horror. He gets... Ed Hellman painted this guy. It's great. We made him up. It's another pilot, Afterburn. This thing is nice because it can be loaded. This thing is loaded with foot picks. Here's Mandrake, leader of the Lady Lasers. I said he's an old friend of Destro, and so he gets to command a squadron of people all by himself because he's a really good guy. A supporter of Destro. Here is another Lady Laser. Put her. Here. There's a reason he's got the backpack instead of one of the ladies, because one of the ladies that I have. Oh, see, this is what happens. This base kind of does fall down. So, as you can see, this is kind of what happens. I kind of forgot about that. I forgot that some of these pieces fall. So. And this is an old Cobra Commander that we just painted a head gold and just kind of took the black of a different costume and I painted red on it and stuff. And so it's a pretty nice figure. I really do like this one. This one I made myself. Well, come on, dude. Apparently, you don't want to cooperate. There. There's a button that you flip, and this whole base can come down. And put her back up here. Him up here because he fell down. We bought from JoeCon 2018 JoeCon. We bought custom figures from this guy and we bought all four of his versions of this figure. Where she's supposed to be like in four different outfits, but we pretend that she had, or this is quadruplets. And so each one's a different character with a different kind of set of abilities. And she's... One's a, like a computer hacker, one's a assassin, one's a sniper. Not just giving them the same kind of boring role. Not just kind of giving her a... Just pretending to be a different type of Baroness. I try to give her an actual kind of thing and... Oh, see? Another one of these, like, things has a stupid trapdoor and... Some of these aren't standing very well. Here's another... Here are the other two lady lasers that I was talking about. Here's one. And each one is kind of a different type of specialty. One's anti-artillery. One's anti-aircraft. One's anti-air. So, if I said that already, sorry. Anti-air, anti-personnel, and anti-artillery. That one, this one doesn't get one, only because she does not have a hole in the back, like many of the other figures. And, I had to put her backpack on him. But that's okay, because he actually looks pretty good with this. And this, oops. Careful, the lasers can come out, so gotta kind of be careful for that. So each one kind of has a different specialty. None of the women aren't really individuals. They're more of a team, like a squadron. This one I just gave a Storm Shadow head, and I just call her White Wraith. Because I think she looks awesome. And I think of her as kind of like this fighter who like sneaks around, and her suit can like camouflage into anything and stuff like that. So I think it kind of might go good with that. Here's the Hooded Horror. No, the Hangman. This is the Hangman. And I'm just going to, for now, if I can get him to do what he's supposed to do. Another one of the things that I have noticed is that the foot pegs are never exactly in the same spot. Oh, and here's the other sister. And here is Iron Enforcer, who does and enjoys doing all of Destro's dirty work. Painted the boots, and now I think I painted the hole. And here is something Venom Lily made, which is really awesome. A breaker. It has the body of Rise of Cobra Ripcord, the legs of a bat, and the head of a 2018 Joe-Con exclusive head. And so they're the breakers. These breakers are the, and there's two of them. And one of the reasons we use these legs is because we were at Joe Fest this year, and Joe Fest said, hey, you gotta have a specific leg for the ripcord figure. Well, I had bought two ripcords, took the legs and put them on the custom figure. And all of a sudden, it was like, well, what do we do with these legs? Well, then she all of a sudden just put them on there, and I thought that looked great. That was just really, really awesome. So, and there's still tons of foot pegs left. So this whole thing is full, just full of foot pegs. Even though it's a Star Wars base,
I could even still put more figures on here. There's more on each side, and there's more on the other side of each, like that side and that side. And there's some down there. And I use that as a landing pad for Destro's despoiler. So it's kind of a... But this is also supposed to be out in space. This is her space fortress for Venom Lily. Well, Ed Hellman and the rest of the space fleet. But I wanted to show you some of the figures that we didn't get to yet. And just kind of keep your, you know, keep your eyes peeled. We'll be doing some more of these figures pretty soon. More next year for Iron Grenadier Month 3. But for right now, this is the finale. I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving. I hope you guys all had wonderful days. I hope you have a good weekend. Very soon, we are going to be doing Advent Calendar. We're going to be starting that on Sunday. But be tuned to tomorrow because we're going to be putting up two unboxings to show you kind of what we got, and I'm hoping you guys will like that, so please stay tuned for that and put a thumbs up and enjoy this video, and we will see you next time. Bye.
Well, thank you for watching our final video of the year. This wasn't really a review per se, but this is the final review of this year. We're going to be doing Advent Calendar, then Christmas, and then it'll be the new year. So thank you for watching,
and we'll see you
next time. Bye.
Your grandma will hate Mohawks.